On March 21st, 4 days after the feast day of Ireland's patron, St. Patrick, the Catholic Church honors St. Enda of Arran, a warrior turned monk considered to be one of the founders of Irish monasticism. Born during the 5th century, Enda inherited control of a large territory in present-day Northern Ireland from his father Conall. His sister Fanchea, however, had already embraced consecrated religious life with a community in Meath and looked unfavorably on the battles and conquests of her brother. Enda is said to have made a deal with his sister, promising to change his ways if he could marry one of the young women of her convent. But this was a ruse on Fanchea's part, as the promised girl died soon. Fanchea forced him to view the girl's corpse to teach him that he too would face death and judgment. In this way, Fanchea, whom the church also remembers as a saint, succeeded in turning her brother not only from violence but even from marriage. He left Ireland for several years, during which time he became a monk and was ordained as a priest. Upon his return to Ireland, he petitioned his King Angus of Munster, who was married to another of Enda's sisters, to grant him land for a monastic settlement on the Arran Islands, a beautiful but austere location near Galway Bay off Ireland's west coast. During its early years, Enda's island mission had around 150 monks. As the community grew, he divided up the territory between his disciples, who founded their own monasteries to accommodate the large number of vocations. Enda did not found a religious order in the modern sense, but he did hold a position of authority and leadership over the monastic settlements of Arran, which became known as Arran of the Saints, renowned for the monks' strict rule of life and passionate love for God. While living on an Irish island, Enda's monks imitated the asceticism and simplicity of the earliest Egyptian desert hermits. The monks of Arran lived alone in their stone cells, slept on the ground, ate together in silence, and survived by farming and fishing. St. Enda's monastic rule, like those of St. Basil in the Greek East and St. Benedict in the Latin West, set aside many hours for prayer and the study of scripture. During his own lifetime, Enda's monastic settlement on the Arran Islands became an important pilgrimage destination, as well as a center for the evangelizations of surrounding areas. At least 24 canonized individuals had some association with Arran of the Saints. St. Enda himself died in old age around the year 530. An early chronicle of his life declared that it would never be known until the Day of Judgment the number of saints whose bodies lie in the soil of Arran. An account of the one-time warrior's response to God's surprising call. Placing all our petitions before him today, let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, that amid the uncertainties of this world, we may cling with all our heart to the things of heaven. For through the Abbot Blessed Enda, you have given us a model of evangelical perfection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen.